Good day, students. In this video, I am going to share with you the solution of problem number 7 from exercise 10 on free surface effects. It is from Capt. Subramaniam's ship stability textbook. The problem states a vessel displacing 8,000 tons has a regular deep tank 10 meters long by 8 meters wide by 9 meters deep. It is full of salt water. The km of the ship is 7 meters and the kg is 6.2 meters. You have to find the gm when one third of the tank is pumped out. So let us go to the solution now. Here is the data from the problem. Displacement is 8,000 tons. Tank dimensions are length, breadth and height weighing 10 meters by 8 meters by 9 meters. Km of the ship is 7 meters. Kg of the ship is 6.2 meters. The density, the relative density of the liquid within the tank is salt water, therefore 1.025. You have to find her GM when one third of the tank has been pumped out. So before we start anything, we need to draw the diagram from the data given to us in the problem. Here is the ship, cross-section view, and here is the deep tank. This is the center line, that is the keel mark. This is the height of the tank being 9 meters. The breadth of the tank is 8 meters and the length of the tank is 10 meters. This is the volume of the liquid, the mass of the liquid that is to be pumped out. One third of the total volume of the tank. Since the height of the total height of the tank is 9 meters, one third is 3 meters. So this part which you see, the colored part, red, orange, yellow, blue, actually the entire range of the rainbow colors is the one that is to be pumped out. And what will remain behind is this 6 meters height of the volume of water will remain behind in the tank. What will happen is now the tank is completely full. It has no free surface effects. After this one third has been pumped out, there will be a free surface effect because this liquid will now be free to move around since the tank has become slack. This is the center of gravity of the ship and that is equal to 6.2 meters. This small g is the center of gravity of the liquid that will be pumped out. It is located at half the height, which is 3 divided by 2, therefore 1.5 meters. From the keel, this is equal to 6 meters, that is from here to the keel is 6 meters, plus 1.5 meter, thus giving it to be 7.5 meters. This is the metacenter of the ship, and the metacenter is located at 7 meters. Thus we see that the kg, the keel, from the keel to the center of gravity of the liquid that is to be pumped out, small g, is 6 plus 1.5, 7.5 meters, and the distance between the center of gravity of the ship and the center of gravity of the volume of water, the weight of water that is to be pumped out, is going to be 7.5 minus 6.2 meters, which is equal to 1.3 meters. Here we see that the one third of the tank has been pumped out and now the water level is at the white dashed line. The water is now below this line. This part has got water and this part is empty, thus the tank is slack. So first we need to calculate the mass of the water that is pumped out. which is equal to the length into breadth into height of the tank multiplied by the relative density of the liquid within the tank, which gives us 10 by 8 by 3 by 1.025, thus giving us that the weight of the water that was pumped out was 246 metric tons. Thus, the new displacement is 8000 minus 246 is equal to 7754 metric tons. The vertical shift of the center of gravity given by GG dash is equal to small w into d divided by capital W minus small w. Small w being the weight of the liquid that was pumped out, and d is the distance between the center of gravity of the ship and the center of gravity of the weight that was pumped out. In this case, the water be 246 metric tons. Capital W was the initial displacement of the ship, and small w is the mass of the water that was pumped out. Thus, we see that this works out to 246 into d is equal to 7.5 minus 6.2, which is 1.3 meters. And divided by 8000 minus 246, thus giving us that the center of gravity of the ship will move by 0.041 meters. Since this water was pumped out from above the center of gravity of the ship, thus the new location of the center of gravity of the ship will be 0.041 meters from the original kg of the ship. So, thus this means that the center of gravity moves downwards by a value equal to gg dash, which is 0.041 meters. Thus, the new kg of the vessel is 6.2 minus 0.041 equal to 6.159 meters. Free surface correction is given by the formula moment of inertia I into relative density of the liquid within the tank divided by the displacement of the tank. Displacement of the ship, I beg your pardon. L into B cube divided by 12 is the formula for the moment of inertia, which we have substituted in place of I into the relative density of the liquid within the tank divided by the final displacement. Thus, we see 10 into 8 cube into 1.025 divided by 12 divided by 7754. This is the final displacement of the ship. And thus, we get free surface correction equal to 0.056 meters. Km given to us was 7 meters. From that, we subtract the kg of the ship after the weight was discharged, which gives us 7 minus 6.159 meters, thus giving us gm solid equal to 0.841 meters. Free surface correction we have calculated here to be 0.056 meters, which we subtract from gm solid to give us a gm fluid of 0.785 meters. Thank you, students, for your kind attention. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, share, as well as subscribe to my channel.